rice in it. No, I'm done. I'm done. We're done. All right, we're kicking.
I am.
I mean, like I said, I got the evidence of you guys being all hyped for it. There's the Oni-chan. I got the evidence of you guys being all hyped for it. I'm saving for about week 7 or 8, and then we'll see how we're still feeling about Gen 2. But until then.
And we will maintain our positivity just to spite you.
Exactly. I just jinxed it now, but. people fire Pokemon, like when they dig Crystal, they're like, oh shit, if you don't pick Cyndaquil, you basically don't get a fire Pokemon until a really long time. They're like, let's put this patch of grass here and add Growlithe in it. And the same thing happened to me. The same thing happened to me when I played Crystal, so I feel your pain. I felt it on a spiritual level with you. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Maybe from fishing, I guess.
But we'll get to that.
Well, more on that later.
Alright, guess that brings it to me. I grabbed my, I've decided, because of my naming scheme, she's my isekai protagonist, Goose the Cyndaquil from Professor Elm. I'm playing Silver version, by the way, just for clarity. I narrowly managed to beat my rival. I think I survived with something like 3 HP
yep.
left after using
it
my
was.
Berry. Was real rough. And then moving into the run proper, just kind of moved along through, caught a bunch of Pokemon. Kibo the Hoothoot, Route 29. Mizuki the Geodude, Route 46. Yudai the Rattata, Route 30. Q the Bellsprout, Route 31. Now the Zubat in Dark Cave. And then got into Violet City, rolled into Sprout Tower right away because I was playing at night, and caught Ike Kush the Ghastly. Yep, and on that note, I moved into Faulkner's gym, declaring double down, so I couldn't use any super effective moves, not that you really have access to any at that point, but 3 points is 3 points is 3 points. Didn't really have a problem with the trainers, but then I had to pull out literally every trick in the book I had against Faulkner, because I suffered a couple unlucky crits early on, and literally defeating that Pidgeotto came down to 3 attacks in a row from that Pidgeotto whiffing, so it didn't kill Goose, because I'd gotten enough smoke screens up, and I was just desperately throwing offense at it. And Ike Kush, too beautiful for this world, he gave his unlife for the cause, no Ghastly for me. But I mourned my losses, I moved on. Route 32, I managed to pick up a Mareep, which I named Makoto. And Union Cave, I quickly realized that I wasn't going to be able to get anything worthwhile on my regular encounter table, so I fished up a Magikarp, named it Battler. Emerging from that, Route 33, I caught a female Ekans, the boss, to honor Solid Snake from my Gen 1 run. And then in Azalea, I just went through, whipped some rockets, caught Yuhai the Slowpoke, and I have to give credit where it's due here. Zed, you were hanging around in my chat and let me know that, hey, you can still get Slowking, which opens up some options, which I'm still considering.
I saw that in the VOD, and I was like, at first I heard you say it, that, like, oh, I can't get Slowpoke, I'm like, no, you can get Slowpoke, and then Zed immediately, like, in the VOD, I'm like, oh, gosh.
Yeah, I was very grateful. I remain grateful. Otherwise, I probably would have just murdered it, and everyone would have cried out, no, Vimbert. Exactly. And then moving into the gym, I declared double down, and then immediately screwed up an input when I so I get no points, and just super effective my way through the gym. Bugsy and his crew were no issues, but thankfully.
Yeah. Don't worry. I'm gonna add a special section that is called "The Homies Give All Each Other Charity" this week. We'll get to it.
Yeah, so there will be a bit more on that later, but that was my week.
Alright, that just leaves me. I'm playing Gold, and I picked my boy Totodile Hitman, an interpret Hitman Heart. We have a professional wrestling naming theme. We went and took our rival's lunch money. I was ready for it this time, unlike Gen 1, where, well, you can't really be ready for it in Gen 1, I guess. it just kind of happens. But I beat him this time, so big ups there. My next two encounters, ironically, were Trish the Pidgey and The Rock, the Geodude. Some spoiler alert. Don't see the end of this story. Route 30, I caught Sasha Banks the Metapod, continuing the tradition where I can't catch a Caterpie. I have to catch the second stage evolution, so it just has Harden, so I have to switch train it. And at Route 31, we went and got a Bellsprout. I don't even remember why I named it, because it was purely to be traded for the Onix. Then we went in the Dark Cave, and because I had already... No, I got Zubat in the Dark Cave, yep. Big Rob Van Dam the Zubat. So then I got to Azalea Town, right? And I was also playing the during the day, so I couldn't go get Ghastly. I did the similar thing to Zed. So I was like, well, right now I don't even have like a full team for Faulkner. I have a Metapod with Harden, so I'm like, what if we go get an unknown? What if we go get an unknown? Because we're doing two gyms this week, and I won't have to bring him to PvP. So I go and I go to the Ruins of Alpha, and I catch Unknown, the Gold Dust, the Unknown, right? And I can't remember if I figured, like, I can't remember who I used in battle, but it immuned it instantly. So it immuned my normal type instantly. I'm like, well, that's not good. That means I can't use it in Faulkner because Pidgey and Pidgeotto are normal flying. So I was like, well, that was... We haven't determined if it's ground or ghost hidden power yet, but it is the letter D, as in dog. So like I said in the chat before, the jokes basically write themselves. The big D. But with that, with no choice, I did the double down on Faulkner, and keeping everybody's level below 9 was harder than the actual gym itself. I think I kind of had a plan going in that involved rage that worked out pretty well, and then it was just a matter of making sure no one overleveled, and then we got that point. We went to Route 32 and got Big Mareep the Goldberg, we got Goldberg the Mareep, and Union Cave came along. Interesting. Well, I'll think about that later. However, we went through Union Cave, no big deal. We get to Route 33, I'm like, okay, we're going to save this route for the headbutts. This is one of the routes where we have a better chance of getting a Heracross. And although Heracross is kind of hot garbage until late game, it would be pretty sweet to have one. So I go and I fight the trainer. And before this, Sasha Banks, my Metapod, had evolved into Butterfree. And I've been using it to kill all the Geodudes in the rock tunnel because none of them have rock throw yet. They're all like, I think the highest level Geodude in there is 9. So I get into a fight with the trainer outside who has a level 11 Geodude. And we were fighting Geodudes, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm just going to switch into Sasha Banks and Confusion this and be over with it. And then as soon as I click switch, I was like, oh no. But I also forgot my typing chart, basically, because I was like, well, Rock's only going to hit me flying, so it's only 2 times, so maybe there's a chance I survive. But that bug type, so it was 4 times weakness.
Yep.
Sasha Banks came out and got Rock Throat and just one-hit KO'd. So we lost our first Pokemon of the run. And after that, I was pretty tilted and pretty done for the day. So next day, we went and... Oh, no, I fished in the Slowpoke. Well, sorry. I was going for that Slowpoke, like Vimber, but I got the Dupes 4, and I was like, man, I'd rather just get Magikarp off the table right now than Dupes out on a route. So we fished up X-Pac, the Magikarp. Then off-stream, we went back to Sprout Tower at night, recorded the video of us getting a Ghastly, and then we moved on... Just taking down the Rockets, and then we went to Bugsley. We declared we were doing hard mode, and we walked in there, handled the trainers just fine. Everything was going good, and I had this big brain plan cutter. And I was like, in my head, I thought the AI was going to use quick attack against me because of the typing. Like, because Togetic's flying typing, I figured the AI would use quick attack. And I'm like, well, that's not good. However, we dropped its attack low enough. So I start rotating in Pokemon, and Fury Cutter just keeps going. It just keeps going. It's like chunking people, and he hasn't missed yet. I brought out our boy, our girl, actually, Rod Van Dam, the Zubat. Got a Supersonic off. Got him out of there. Brought out Geodude, the Rock, hoping that Supersonic would hit and break the thing. And it didn't. And Scyther one-shotted my Geodude with Fury Cutter. And it, like, I brought him out. It was Scyther's confused no more. I'm like, uh-oh. And then Fury Cutter, like, straight one-shotted Geodude. And I was like, well, there's death number one.
I swear your stream, like, slowed down when that was happening.
Yeah. So at that point, it was just, like, hoping for a Scyther miss, you know? So I bring Trish out, my Pidgey. Pidgey gets one-tapped by Fury Cutter. So I bring Rob Van Dam back out, who's at half HP at this point. And I get another Supersonic off, and he hits me and brings Rob Van Dam down to 3 HP. But he landed the confusion, and thankfully the next turn he hit himself in the confusion, so the Fury Cutter chain was broken. But I'm pretty sure as soon as the Geodude went down in one hit, I think my thought process was, yep, I'm waving in Bugsley right now. So
I think you might have even said it.
I did. I said it out loud. I said it out loud multiple times. I was like, I'm waving to Bugsley right here. Like, it's happening. Like, holy shit. So the moral of the story is maybe don't do that one hard mode. We got the hard mode win, but at great cost.
Great cost.
Yeah, no, but yeah. See, you had similar issues with Faulkner with the AI, too. You were like, maybe it's just the AI getting a little better from Gen 1 to Gen 2. Because remember, Pidgeotto wasn't mudslapping your Cyndaquil? Remember?
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Because you brought your Cyndaquil in, and then he just gusted you instantly, and you're like, wait a minute. Like, but, so, I got played
by
the AI.
Wait, that's Eagle.
Yeah, exactly. All right, before we do Honor the Fallen, let's talk about the charity. So, all of our hosts had charity this week. Talk about it. Let's talk about our individual charities. I'll go last because mine requires the most blabbering about.
Yeah. My charity was I declared double down going into Bugsy's gym, and then immediately screwed it up, and past that I was like, alright, well, I guess I'll just do the gym normally, because under our regular rules, screwing up double down should mean I get 0 points, but the guys were gracious, and since we all had some scuff, decided I could get points for just a regular gym win.
And, like, I was thinking, like, in my head, if I've ever done that, like, when I'm switching a move about, because that was, like, I was like, yeah, that's something that all could have happened, so. Oh, did you?
Oh.
Yeah. I know for sure I did it in, like, my either Gen 1 or Gen 2 view lock, but I don't know whatever, but I had a little sympathy for that. So then my sympathy was, our original rule was, basically, you bring the team you end the gym with to the PvP. And that's how we were going to go into it. And then I think my fellow host saw that, yeah, it's not that great when you take a big L in PvE. It's good for content. It's fun to watch. And it's suffering. It's delicious. But you basically forfeit PvP, though. Like, or you don't forfeit it, but you go in there, like, heavily down, and we didn't think that's, like, the greatest viewing content for everybody that's watching. So the rule we added now is that you will have a roster of 8 for your gym battles. So you'll have the 6 Pokemon that are on your team that you go into the gym with, and then you'll have 2 in reserve that if you take casualties in the gym, you can bring in your reserves. And you just have to declare those 2 in reserves before you go into the gym, is the thing. tackle. You look on the lookout.
Oh,
and
baby.
You respond to the unknown by putting in a normal or flying type. That's basically all you gotta do. But
true.
Now I think, Vim, if you want to take it away, honoring the fallen first, say any parting words for.
Yeah. So I this is all. It was almost. I was thinking about it earlier today. It was almost prophesized. I'm doing a naming theme where it's visual novel characters, and when I caught a Ghastly, it was like, he's not exactly from a visual novel, and basically from that point, Ike Cush's fate was sealed, I feel like. I was super excited to have Hypnosis really early. I was like, this is going to be great, super useful, and I was just excited to run a Ghastly, because last time I felt like it came along a little too late for me to really consider. Also, we have, you know, Impossible Evos, who could have become a Gengar. Looking forward to it, and like his sacrifice absolutely let me get through Faulkner, but it was a harsh one. He will be missed.
Yeah, he felt my Ghastly curse. Must have passed it on.
I did.
No mean look either, kind of hurts. But
yeah,
I think Zubat gets it, doesn't he? I think
sounds great.
Actually, a lot.
Yeah.
Headbutt tree Pokemon run away. Yeah, there's a bunch of Pokemon that can flee. They immediately got rid of it after Gen 2 because they realized how dumb it was. It's just legendaries after Gen 2, but
yeah.
It is still very much a thing in Gen 1, or Gen 2. Alright, so my fall on Sasha Banks, the Butterfree. You know, that one's on me. Not knowing my typing chart, you'd think after a whole generation of Nuzlocke and three completed Nuzlocke before that I would know that Bug is weak to rock, but apparently I didn't, or I just had been playing so long at that point. I don't know. That one was on me. And then the AI output, the 23-year-old AI outplayed me in Bugsley's gym, basically, is the other two. Trish and bye-bye Butterfree. My favorite episode of the anime was that.
Your Butterfree wasn't going to be okay, Dad.
Yeah, it's because it wasn't named Bobby. It couldn't protect itself. Bobby made it all the way. But no, then the other two was, the AI outplaying me. And, you know, the Pidgey, the loss of Trish, the Pidgey is, it sucks. Because Gust is actually a flying move now. So Pidgey's, like, infinitely better than it was in Gen 1.
Much better.
But there's also, like, you can basically guarantee a Spearow, Big Kenya, if you need to. So I'll have a flying option there. And then Zubat is a Crobat that learns flying moves and flying stab. So that one doesn't hurt. However, losing Dwayne the Rock Geodude Johnson is a harsh toke with Whitney coming up next week. So I figured out, it took me a while when I did the Hulock, but I eventually came up with a pretty surefire way to beat Whitney, but that plan is no longer on the table with my Geodude, so we're going back to the drawing boards tomorrow when I do my stream for that. You still got Onyx, yeah, but Onyx doesn't have a fucking drop of offensive ability to get through the Whitney.
Really doesn't.
No, he's just there to get stomped on and get attracted. And all my Pokemon are men, basically, too, except for my Zubat, so that's also another. Yep, female starters. Which was insane.
Yeah, I definitely got a strong girl squad on my file as well.
Yep. Yeah, so this week was a bloodbath in gyms. Whitney will probably be an experience, to say the least. So stay tuned on that on Thursday. But
God knows I will.
Plug aside for the individual stream. We got some follow-alongs. Vimbert, if you want. We only got two follow-alongs. Tis, tis.
Oh.
Other boomers. I know that we got people playing, but I didn't get any follow-alongs besides these two. So if you want to take Inceptions that I sent you in the DMs, I believe.
Sure, yeah. So Inception says, yo, for my update, I don't have much time, but I didn't lose any Pokemon, though Faulkner was a bitch. My starter is Totodile, which I named Sasuke. Caught a Spearow, Sentret, Growlithe, Zubat, Geodude, Bellsprout, who I traded for Onix, Rattata, Geodude, Hatch the Pugsy with was Onix, Growlithe, Totodile, Ekans, Ferret, and Butterfree. Pretty
There you
strong.
go. That big vamp people.
Yeah.
Too, like Dark Cave.
Very low odds,
Very
I
low
think.
odds in Dark Cave, yeah. Unfortunately, Phanpy doesn't have he has kinda he has Heracross moves, basically.
Yeah.
But yeah, all normal, really bad ones. No, I don't even think he gets countered. He doesn't get a ground move for a while, I don't think. But I'm hyped for the Phanpy as well. It'll be fun to see him. Hopefully in
Yeah.
DC tonight. Excuse me.
Oh, Inception saying not Dark
Dark
Cave in
Cave.
chat. Where was that at then?
Where's that? Oh, 46.
46.
Wow.
Oh.
Hm.
I
That is
forgot
big.
about that.
Dunsparce is one in the Dark Cave. The big
Right.
Dunsparce, baby.
Literally 1%, I believe.
I think you crystal players can get Teddy Ursa in the Dark Cave as well for 1%.
Sounds correct.
All right.
Dude, solid.
I had a yeah. I remember the timeline where I had a Geodude. It was pretty cool. But bot lane also following along. New follow along for this season. He's one of our regular competitors in the Pokeboomers Grand Prix. However, he's finally thrown his hat in the ring in the Nuzlocke. So, bot lane says, "We made it through the first gym, cutting it close for Dr. Hoot." The Hoot Hoot. Little did I know that it was a prophecy, an ill omen. I forgot where the next rival battle was. Dr. Hoot was a hero, a savior. We lost him, but they didn't lose us. And then I threw some pebbles at Bugsy and walked away rich as fuck. So he triggered the rival battle in Azalea
Oh.
Town. Yo. Yeah, that's a. As someone who was wiped to that rival battle, the strength in me honors the strength in you for making it through.
Yeah. That fight's very rough.
Yeah, I had a Cyndaquil, and I just had nothing for the Croconaw, and the Croconaw just came out and like fucking killed my whole team, and I was like, well, that was cool.
Fair.
I think Vim will be all right with his Bellsprout though.
Yeah, I got
The
Bellsprout and
next,
Mareep. I'm gonna be fine.
yeah, the next time I did it, I didn't have Mareep for the Plant Crystal, but I made sure I had a Bellsprout that time around, so.
Wise.
So it's just don't die to it's not just get wrecked by Croconaw, but I don't know. What'd you guys think about your first week in the PvE side of it?
It was everything I expected it to be.
Yeah. Yeah. Pretty easy.
Yeah.
Get it, man.
It's like it's the reason for the name. Wow.
It's like yeah, I wasn't expecting. I knew someone was bound to get it, but I did not think that. I figured it would happen when we're all mindlessly grinding, like, or I. Oh, yeah, exactly. It was like first hour, like live on stream. There's also a 1 in 16th chance you get a shiny out of the egg in crystal, but yeah, I remember watching and like, and then also it was like, wait, is that a shiny? And like, we had to do some quick research, and yeah, it was in fact a shiny Sentret. So that's hype. But now I think it's time for that. Oh, absolutely.
Definitely.
Huge can be the mascot of my team too. Huge is a sweet boy. Sweet boy. I don't know if I could raise a Pokemon fist towards him. We'll see if I'll be paralyzed by the swagger in battle, because it's me and you first. There's Zed if you want to send the invite. As we jump into our PvP section. Dun dun dun.
fact still holding because of Gen 2 changes. Yeah,
spoiler,
that's what
it does.
Hitman comes out for Hugh as the first damage goes out on turn 3 with Lucky hitting him with a rock throw. The pivot back to Trainwreck. Scratch hitting for minor damage, Bayleaf tankiness and Reflect combining there. Zubat. Oh, immunes the poison powder as Reflect fades. Comes back out. Super effective leech life. Chip damage, but that is would have been a little bit of healing back.
Bayleaf could be a fucking problem.
Yep.
Season.
classic tackle goes out, but Trainwreck gets confused. Swap to Bloodsport, the Butterfree. Resisting that leech life. Getting a little bit of health back on that Zubat. Rob Van Dam. Swap to Goldberg, the Flaffy. Confusion hitting for a little bit of damage. Flaffy pretty tanky, special-wise. Sleep Powder connects. Goldberg taking a nap. Swap to Big Rocky.
Oh.
Confusion only hitting for around 26%. I'm personally a bit surprised.
Don't worry, we'll make up for it with our offensive stat.
And Rock Throw goes out for minor damage on Trainwreck, who comes into that rock. Screech as Reflect gets set up. I think that nulls it out for Trainwreck. Could be wrong. Razor Leaf hits a Rob Van Dam coming in. As Hugh's team just shucks and jives and switches around, trying to find that opening. Supersonic confusing the Butterfree, who's just come out. There's that first self-damage as Bite goes out. Stun Spore connecting, but Paralysis does not take as another Bite happens on that Butterfree. We're seeing the Blood Sport. Confusion, huge damage. Rob Van Dam just continues biting like it's his job. Eats a berry, back up to half health. Her job, sorry. With the name, I was...
There it is.
John Cena with some minor damage from that confusion. Do we see the big metronome attempt? Stun Spore whiffs. No, it's Swift. Stab Swift doing some surprising damage there. Stun Spore goes out. And so does Swift. Zed with the first faint. But Lucky the Geodude's here to avenge. Bad matchup for John Cena, particularly paralyzed, but do you try to... Oh, Rock v. Rock. Understandable. Rocky a little bit banged up, though. We'll see if that factors into things. I'm pretty sure an Onyx. Oh, Magnitude. Magnitude 6. Big damage for Hitman, who immediately eats the berry. The first of many magnitude gambles we're likely to see during this gen. Water
Ooh.
Gun, one hit KO. Geodude goes down. Trainwreck comes out. Battle of the starters. It is possible to go to five head in Pokemon. They stare each other down. Oh. As the classic Reflect opener gets set up. Safe switch for John. But still carrying that paralysis.
Oh, God.
Huge! Mighty huge. As Metronome comes out with Payday, John Cena looking for a little bonus from this title card.
We get that showdown money.
Stab Swift coming out from Zedward's side. Metronome Mud Slap. Lowering that accuracy. Small damage, but accuracy drop could be big. Could be huge. Oh, but not with Swift, right?
Yeah.
As John Cena's paralyzed. I mean, theoretically, you could use a move other than Swift, but I don't know why you would at this point in the game. As John Cena down, right? Crybaby coming out for Van Damme healing back up a little bit. And Mighty Huge sees that leech life and is like, alright, you may have a little of my greatness.
Oh no.
Oh god, crit swift! Can anything stop Huge?
I don't think so.
We're 3-3 on teams. Rocket resisting that swift. Reflect helping to blunt that rock throw. Both getting a little banged up. It's a war of attrition at this point. And a miss on rock throw. As Reflect fades. Rocky hangs in there. Rock throw connects. Huge also getting low. Rocky barely holds on. Critical health. It's a question of speed now, and we've seen who wins that as Rocky takes the KO. But Huge now incredibly low. 4% as Hitman comes in. He's accepted the contract. Swift for Huge damage. Rage. Oh, Rage. Oh. Interesting. Trainwreck comes out to replace on Zedward's side. Reflect goes out. Hitman stays in with Rage. Razor Leaf drops Hitman down, but allows Hugh to get that clean switch into, oh, Sleeping Gold Jerk, right. Your MC forgot about that, ladies and gentlemen, and other configurations of being. Still sleepy eating that berry, though. A little midnight snack, but there's a Razor Leaf crit, and Zed takes the win.
There you go.
Yeah.
A Bailey, though. All right.
Very, very. It's
there
crazy that you get it that early.
I was a Bayleaf stan in this whole lock. I'm here for it. Oh, are you guys? No, you guys already.
Showdown is doing its thing. It logged me out randomly. Sorry.
No, you're good.
All right, we're in.
Difficulty thing. Sorry, struggling to search. There you guys are. And 1 second. Boom. All right, ladies and gentlemen in the audience and my two fellow competitors, Bimbert, standing tall in the silver corner, and Zed in his crystal palace with Trainwreck, Starter v Starter, and Goose. Gentlemen, let's go to war. There's the quick swap to Geodude as Ember goes out. 20% damage still and gets the burn off. That is huge, folks. Cutting
Gamble
that
attack!
Here's, oh god, I'm gonna need like a naming chart. How I say that?
Q.
Q? Okay. Q takes 40% health from that magnitude 8. Big high roll there. Would have been a one hit KO probably without that burn. No, maybe it wouldn't have been. It'd be close. Here's the Vine Whip, though. Says, one and done. Get on out of here. We see the first casualty of this battle as the Geodude goes down. Here comes Bloodsport, the Butterfree. Q standing strong, holding steady. What is his plan? It's not a plan. Here comes Kibo coming in, taking him 20% on the confusion. However, that Hoot Bolt. Perhaps we'll see it play out here. Paralyze goes out. Bloodsport Hypnosis goes wide. Confusion again, 20%. And Parafusion has been set, folks. Kibo hurts itself in confusion. Kibo eats a berry. Recovers a little bit of that HP. Just a little quick snack. Num, 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 num. Confusion again. Power the full para this time. Parafusion's like, what if you wanted to play the game of Pokemon? But I said no. Here comes Makoto the Flaffy coming in on that confusion, taking 18%. Sleep Powder finds its mark. Bloodsport doing work for Zedward here in this battle. It's okay, I also had a sleepy Phanpy I fought Zed?
He's a pretty forgettable Pokemon. It's true.
Hell yeah, brother. Wow. Is that the first time that's happened?
It's happened before, like
not
once or
me.
twice.
Not against me, it hasn't.
Oh, God. this, my friend.
One act to drop.
Holy fuck. Completely derailed me.
Oh. Please, please, ultimate lucky student.
God. Oh.
I don't think so.
Oh.
Oh. Damn it.
The Starry Boys. Oh my god.
Smokescreen, I love you!
Holy good game, man. Jeez.
Great, man.
Oh my god, what was that?
My brain eventually just like, alright, we have to shift into Faulkner tactics here.
It seems like we played each other a few times in Pokemon the way we were switching into each other's stuff too as well.
Yep. Yep, just a little bit. Oh.
Oh.
My god.
I was like, hey, we're doing pretty good on episode time. What if I had a 62 turn battle with level 16 Pokemon?
This is why I was happy to get Cyndaquil, though. You get Smokescreen.
Smokescreen's
That's
really
all
good.
You need, baby.
The stand attack in Gen 2 is now ground, so a lot of stuff can get around it.
Right.
Okay, so Big Zed, our big winner for the night, with 30 PvP points, moves you up to 115, correct?
Dang.
Vimber stays at 65.
80 with the charity adjusted.
Yep. Charity adjusted 80.
Yeah.
And then I am at 110, so trailing right behind. Big Zedward. It's still anybody's race.
Absolutely.
However, gentlemen, next week, there comes a time in every Gen 2 Nuzlocke where you gotta pay the Piper. And that Piper's name is Whitney. And
yeah.
For no point. So what does Whitney mean? It means our level cap goes to 20. It's a big level cap for next week. We're only doing one gym. Yeah, we thought I have some stuff going on in that their real world that I exist in sometimes, and we figured Whitney deserved her own week, kind of. You got
yeah.
a lot of encounters potentially along the way as well. The map kind of doesn't open up necessarily. You're still blocked by our boy Pseudo Widow, but
there's a lot of cool stuff you can do in Goldenrod.
Yeah, I must say there's.
You got the underground path, game corner if you want to do gambling now that it's less awful.
I think there's like 5 encounters still this week too. I'm trying to.
There's.
Yep.
Yeah. Yep.
Forest,
get that.
Goldenrod.
Yeah. National Park.
National Park, and then there's the route.
Yep. There's more trainers up there too, so.
You get your egg too, Zed. And you get your egg, and Vimbert and I get Route 31. Encounter.
Yeah. Unless we choose to save for Pseudo Widow.
Oh, yeah, and I get to use Headbutt the trees for the routes I didn't use. I'm going to make a mental note of that.
Yeah, Headbutt begins.
Yeah, buddy. It's gonna go from this meta to everybody that can use Headbutt will have Headbutt meta.
Yep. The meta this possible answer.
It would have been pretty good. Yeah, let's say. I have Charm and Growl on John Cena, so I bet you I could afford to get rid of one of those.
I suppose, yes.
big ups to the Payday Metronome, though. I didn't
pay
Zed, so I don't get the money. Damn it. I got paid Zed in IRL. Hit me with your Venmo after this. But, alright. If you guys want to plug your streams in the chat while we wrap up. If you're here already, you know I'm here. So this is my channel, and I will be streaming tomorrow at 1 p.m. I'm not going to be doing Whitney. The goal is to get all my encounters and get everything I have on the board, and then take some days to kind of think about what I need to do, because like I said, without that Geodude, it becomes a lot more complicated. So.
And also just behold the carnage from Zed and I battling Whitney.
Yeah, maybe it'll make me feel better. Maybe you guys, if one of you just, there was talk of the tactical wave when I was watching the VOD.
Yeah.
The tactical wave.
When I was getting Giga Salty, and I was like, well, I'm getting